Hi, my name is Madeline Steer and I've just finished my second year of engineering at Jesus College, Cambridge. I applied in 2012 and matriculated in 2013. I'm going to go through two interview questions which are taken from the website iwanttostudyengineering.org, which is a website which has hundreds of engineering interview type questions with work through answers and occasionally videos too. And the two questions that I'm going to do are similar to the kind of question that I got during my interview. So hopefully this will help.
So the first question reads as follows. On a clear day, you are on an aeroplane which is at 38,000 feet above the middle of the Pacific Ocean. Taking the radius of the Earth to be 6,400 kilometres, what is the approximate distance between you and the horizon of the Earth? And it is also given that 1 foot is equivalent to 0.3048 metres.
So the first thing that I would do is convert the 38,000 feet into metres using the given conversion. So 38,000 feet times by 0.3048 metres is roughly, using a calculator, 11.6 kilometres. So now that you have all of the figures in metres or kilometres, you can then draw a diagram of the Earth, like so, with the centre here, and you could say that the aeroplane is here-ish. So now, marking the distances on, you know that this, the radius of the Earth, is 6,400 kilometres. I'm just going to say all the distances are in kilometres. And then the distance from the plane to the Pacific Ocean is, as we calculated here, 11.6 kilometres. So now we need to think about where the horizon is. So the horizon is the line of sight from where you are in the aeroplane to the furthest point that you can see. And by definition, or by intuition, you can say that that point has to be at right angles with the radius of the Earth, because if you're looking at it this way and say that this is your line of sight and this is always the horizon, and it's essentially where your line of sight is horizontal with the circumference of the Earth. And so if we then draw the radius of the Earth on to this point, you know that this has to be a right angle. And so from then on, it's essentially a Pythagoras question. So again, this is the radius of the Earth. And you are trying to find the approximate distance between you and the horizon. So if we call this x, that's this distance here. So then if we redraw the triangle, we have x here, 6,400 kilometres here, and in total 6,411.6 here. And so by Pythagoras, which in full, of course, is this, and by rearranging this to get x as the result, you find that x, the approximate distance between you and the horizon of the Earth, is roughly 386 kilometres. The second question, which I'm going to go through, goes as follows. A rocket of mass M is to be launched from the surface of a rogue planet with mass capital M and radius capital R and no atmosphere. By making reasonable assumptions about the distance between the planet and any nearby galaxies, find the escape velocity required for the rocket to overcome the gravitational field of the planet. You might be wondering what the reasonable assumptions mentioned in the questions might mean, and you just really need to think about what the effect of other planets close by to this planet might be. So if there were planets close to the rogue planet, it's likely that their gravitational field would have an effect on the motion of the rocket, and therefore the assumption that you need to make is the distance between this planet and any nearby planets is very, very large, and therefore only the gravitational field of the rogue planet is important in this question. So for this question, I would go straight into drawing a diagram as it might make it clearer what you need to do to solve this problem. So say this is the planet, and we can mark on here that this is the radius, big R. Now if we draw the rocket to be here at any moment in time, we can label the distance from the rocket to the center of the Earth as little r. So this is just something that we can define. Say in another given time, the rocket has now moved. So it's got a little bit further, and we're going to say that the distance between this instant and this instant is delta r, just to symbolize a little distance. So we know that as the rocket is moving, there must be a force due to the gravitational field of this planet acting on the rocket. And this force is going to be in this direction, which we can call big F. And we know that at this instance, it will also be acting, obviously with a different value, which is given by the formula F equals big G, and then the mass of the planet, which is capital M, the mass of the body upon which the force is acting, which is little m, over the distance between the two bodies, which we have defined as r squared. Now with kinetic energy questions, you often immediately think of energy balancing equations. So this might help in this problem. So one energy balance equation that we know is that the work done is equal to force times distance. So although we don't quite know how we're going to get to kinetic energy through this, it might be worth a try. So we know that the force on the rocket is going to be given by the equation that we just wrote down. And if you don't remember this equation in your interview or you haven't seen it before, just as an example, in an interview, if you can't think of the equation or you really don't know it, if you just state it and, you know, say, oh, I'm really sorry, I don't think I can quite remember the formula for this, they will usually give it to you as it will help you solve the problem, and they don't want you to just stop in your tracks. So they will help you if you forget things that might be useful. So yeah, so force times this force times the little distance. So we're working out the work that's done for the rocket moving from here to here. So we'll do it times delta R. Now this here is just an equation for the little amount of work done moving the rocket from this position to this position, which is just an arbitrary small distance. So to get the total amount of work that will be needed to get the rocket from the surface of the Earth, as specified in the question, all the way to outside the gravitational field of the planet, we will need to sum all these little works done from big R to infinity, which is where the gravitational field of the planet will end. Now, if this isn't an intuitive step and you weren't to get it in the interview, the interviewers may again help you, so that you might be able to proceed further with the question. So don't panic. So therefore, the total work done, which I'm just going to write as W, will be equal to the integral between big R, so the radius of the planet, and infinity of this. And now you can see it's just an integral that we need to calculate to get the work done. So to do the integral, you can rewrite the over r squared as r to the minus 2, which makes it easier. And then you can see that by adding 1, dividing by the new power, you get minus r to the minus 1, which you can then put on the bottom again, between r and infinity. Now this, when you put the limits in, the first limit that you put in is infinity. Obviously dividing by infinity is just going to give you 0. And then the next step is you're doing minus and then inserting large R. And so you'll end up with a minus minus big G, big M, little m over big R. Now this is just the total work done. So I've just moved the result of this integral up here to save space for the next bit of the question. So as I said at the beginning, when you think of kinetic energy questions, you may think of work done and energy balance equations. So now we have the total work needed to get the rocket from here to outside the gravitational field. Now, through energy balance, you know that the work done that is needed to do this must be equal to the initial kinetic energy that the rocket has when it's at the surface of the planet. And so therefore we can write that the result of our integral must be equal to half mv squared. And from now on, it's just rearranging to find v, which is the escape velocity as specified in the question. So mv squared is 2gmm over big R. And so therefore, in the end, you get v is equal to 2g big M over R, as the two m's cancel, and the whole thing square rooted. And then this is the formula for the escape velocity. So those were the two interview questions. I hope you found them useful. If you want to see any more, go to the website that I mentioned earlier, iwanttostudyengineering.org. But if I were to give any tips for the interview, I would say try not to panic. I know it's really hard and obviously you're going to feel stressed, but if you forget anything in the spur of the moment, if you misremember an equation, or if you just literally can't see where this question is going, don't be afraid to admit that. The interviewers are there to help you, and I'm sure teachers or whoever might have been telling you that already, and you may not believe it, but it is true. They will try and help you through a question, and they won't just leave you in the lurch. They just want to test you with things that you haven't seen before. So maybe using equations that you might have seen in maths and physics, for example, the gravitational force equation, and then use it in a way that you might not be familiar with. So they just want to see how well you pick up new concepts, or at least that's the idea that I got from my interview and from speaking to my interviewers, who are now also my supervisors. That is generally the thing that they tried to do, or at least in my college, that's what they try and do. So yes, try not to panic. Don't be afraid to admit if you don't know something. I quoted F M equals A in my interview and they still let me in, so don't worry if you slip up. And try and enjoy it. These are some of the most intelligent academics in the engineering field who will be interviewing you probably, and they really are there to try and test you obviously, but they will also help you through it. So they're not the enemy. So yeah, hopefully that was useful, and I wish you all good luck.